Today I will speak about Go, but not only about Go, also about containers. More exactly about Docker containers. So what is a Docker container? A container is a standardized unit of software, so a way to package our applications in an isolated environment. So what is a Docker container? It's just a container running on top of Docker. In comparison with virtual machines, which are an abstraction of physical hardware, containers are an abstraction at the application layer. So they are a less heavy way to get isolated environments for our applications. But how does Docker work? First of all, as you can see the image, you have to write a Docker file where you will define all the things that will be in the container. Then, through the Docker build command, you can turn out this Docker file into a Docker image, which is like a snapshot. And finally, at the end, with Docker run, you can start a new Docker container with the status of the image previously defined in the Docker file. In addition, a Docker image works like a stack of layers, where each layer is like an intermediate image. So when you want to build an image for your applications, you can start from scratch, so from an image that contains nothing. You can start from an image that contains all the dependencies of a Linux distribution, like Debian, or you can also start from an image that contains all the things of an already set up environment, like Go. So let's an example. In this example, we have dockerized an application that's called Bacom Ipsum, like a Lorem Ipsum generator, but a bit funnier. So in this case, we are compiling our application and we are running the binary on top of an image that contains all the Golang development environment on top of Debian. So as we have our binary, of course, we don't need the development environment. So we can just run from Debian. Of course, we don't need a large distribution like Debian to run our binaries. So we can also run it from a minimalist Linux distribution like Alpine. Of course, if we go further, we can run our applications from scratch. And in terms of size, we have reduced very much the size of our images from 779 megabytes to 5.31 megabytes. But does size matter? Yes, of course. But also security matter. This is why Google guys has developed distroless, which is an image for production-ready environments. This image has all the needed stuff to have a security-friendly images, but also has no package manager, so it provides us an immutable image, which is a good practice, but also it has no access, shell access, so a potential attacker can get into a container to see secrets, configurations, and so on. Thank you.